and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight we have a book called Strictly No Elephants. It's written by Lisa Manchev and illustrated by Taeyoon Yu. My friend in Minnesota, Miss Freya, asked me to dedicate a book to her best friend, Addison. So Freya and Addison, this one is for you. I know your friendship is so very special, and I hope you enjoy this story that is about friendship and inclusion and kindness. I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. The trouble with having a tiny elephant for a pet is that you never quite fit in. No one else has an elephant. An elephant isn't your normal kind of pet, is it? We might have a dog or a cat or a gerbil or a turtle. Nobody really owns an elephant for a pet. Every day I take my elephant for a walk. His is a very thoughtful sort of walk. He doesn't like the cracks in the sidewalk much. I always go back and help him over. That's what friends do. Lift each other over the cracks. Today, I'm walking my tiny elephant to number 17. It's pet club day, and everyone will be there. Come along. There's a good boy. I coax him the last few feet. It'll be fine. When I look up, there's a sign on the door. The sign says, Strictly no elephants. Oh no, they can't go to pet club day? My tiny elephant leads me back to the sidewalk, never minding the cracks. That's what friends do, brave the scary things for you. How do you think the boy and his elephant feel? Sure, they feel sad, they feel left out. There they are, trudging along slowly back home. Did you try to go to the pet club meeting too? The girl asks. Yes, I say, but they don't allow elephants. The sign didn't mention skunks, the girl says, but they don't want us to play with them either. They don't know any better, I tell her. So maybe the boy and this girl could be friends, since they both have unusual pets. Maybe they can at least cheer one another up for the day. What do you think? Let's keep reading and find out what happens. He doesn't stink, the girl adds. No, he doesn't, I agree. Hey, what if we start our own club? Come along, I say, making certain that my tiny elephant follows me, because that's what friends do, never leave anyone behind. Look, I see some more unusual pets. Do you see the giraffe sticking his head out the window? Do you see a penguin up here? Oh, look at all these boys and girls that have unusual pets. There's a narwhal in a fishbowl. There's an armadillo. And what is this? Right, a porcupine. We can play here, one of our new friends say. All of us. So we paint our own sign. And this one says, all are welcome. My tiny elephant will give you directions if you need them. Because that's what friends do. The end. I think that's a wonderful story about kindness, right? And making sure that we include everyone so that no one feels left out. Because that's not a very nice feeling. No one wants to feel left out. So we need to be kind and friendly and welcoming to everyone. So I love that story. Freya and Addison, I hope you liked it too. We're gonna sing two lullabies and then bid each other good night. Let's sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, followed by God Bless the Moon. Sign and sing with me. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me. And God bless you, all my friends at home. As always, thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you again real soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.